Yes, Christine. So we're here at the Central Pacific Hurricane Center with Tom Evans, who's one of the meteorologists we've been speaking with all morning long. And of course, the biggest topic that we've been talking about for the past couple of hours was that 5 o'clock update. So can you share us what is provided in that update?
Yeah, in the update, we actually see Hurricane Lane weakening. It's now down to a Category 2 hurricane, so 110 miles an hour near its center. The hurricane force winds extend out about 35 miles, and the tropical storm force winds extend out to 140 miles is what they change. So it actually increased in size with respect to the tropical storm force wind radii.
And when we're talking about the track, which of course everybody's keeping their eyes on, as that dramatic curve to the west could potentially keep us out of a lot of dangerous impacts, what's the latest with the tracks that have come in?
Yeah, well, the track, you can see, stays pretty much the same. We're going to go north, and then early Saturday morning, we're expecting that to turn toward the west. You can see the cone of uncertainty, which is where the track could actually end up here. The center of the storm could end up here. That's why we continue to have the hurricane warnings for Maui County and Oahu, because if it does take this right-hand track, we will be right in that hurricane force winds. So the track is fairly similar to what we had in the previous advisory.
And when we're talking about this cone of uncertainty, and we know Justin Cruz have kind of talked about this yesterday, can you explain about the actual cone and the width of it being so wide in the near future?
Right, so what we do is we take our averages over the last 5 years and see what our errors are, our forecast errors. And what we do is we take about two-thirds of that, and that's what makes this cone. And as we go further out in time, our errors increase because of forecast uncertainty, and that's why it expands. So this is a three-day forecast, and so that's why 3 days out, our errors are greater, so is the cone of uncertainty.
So even though the islands may not be within that cone, that doesn't mean that there's nothing to worry about, correct?
Correct, because that's the center of the storm, remember. So the center of the storm, if the center of the storm is here on this edge, you can see that hurricane force winds, even going out 35 miles, would be affecting Maui County and Oahu.
Now that we're downgraded to a regular hurricane from a major hurricane, what can still a Category 2 impact? How can that still impact the islands very dangerously?
Oh, yeah, we still have the winds. Right now we are getting some winds on Oahu to the Big Island that are at tropical storm force, just pockets of them. But we also have the heavy rain that we are expecting, especially moving now more towards Maui and Maui County and Oahu, and the large surf and storm surge. Since this is a slow-moving system, about 5 miles per hour north, we do have a lot of water to be piling up and moving into Maui County and Oahu later tonight.
When we're talking about that speed, some may take the number now moving slower as an indication for them that the system is weakening. Is that something that we can judge the strength of the hurricane by?
Well, no, the speed is dependent upon the atmosphere as a whole and what's actually steering it. Now, there is some influence of the storm itself, but slow or fast, you can't tell weakening or strengthening. The weakening is going to be due to dry air or to wind shear or cold water.
And we want to get to some questions from our viewers that have been submitting in. One deals with, again, that dramatic curve. What causes that dramatic curve to possibly take place?
Right. So right now, the mid part of our atmosphere is controlling the movement of Hurricane Lane. And as we continue to have more and more wind shear, we're expecting to have the top of this to be kind of pulled or separated from the actual low level. And the low level circulation then would be more influenced by our trade winds. And so that's what we're going to be expecting. As we have the weakening storm and it being torn apart slowly by the wind shear, it'll be the low level circulation that will continue to move this way as the top of the storm is then moved off to the northeast.
So now with this track, again, still heading northward, and we're not too sure how or when that curve will take place, even if that curve does take place and the system moves westward and doesn't make landfall, especially for Oahu, which is in a direct line with the system now, what can we still for sure get impacted with?
Well, we're going to have the winds, we're going to have the heavy rain, we're going to have the high surf and the storm surge. All those things are still going to happen if it takes a turn or not. If it doesn't take the turn, we're going to have even more and stronger impacts for Oahu, Maui County, and for Kauai.
And then one more question from our viewers, and that really has to do with this wind shear. And of course, at this point, wind shear is like one of those top topics of discussion, as that's that main piece that we're waiting for to see what the result will be on the system. Where is that wind shear located around the islands?
Right. So what we have is we have an upper level trough that's bringing southwest winds across mainly Maui County through Kauai and north westward. So this strong wind aloft is what's causing the wind shear and pulling of the system, top of the system, kind of tilting it, so to speak. So that wind shear is all over our islands right now.
And is that forecasted to strengthen when we're talking about the wind shear in the near future?
Yeah, as you go north, as Hurricane Lane goes north, the wind shear increases. And so as it moves this direction, actually, we will still be in wind shear, but it will pretty much stay about the same as it moves to the west.
And the last hit we had, we talked about hurricanes not really making landfall very much in Hawaii. Does wind shear always have a constant play in our islands, which may be another contributing factor why systems come so close but may not necessarily make landfall?
Yeah, we have some protection most of the time from the stronger winds aloft. If you ever flown out to Hawaii or back to U.S. mainland, it's always faster to fly to the mainland than it is to fly back to Hawaii. That's because of those upper-level winds that we have over the Pacific.
And I'm assuming, so that's part of the jet stream, per se, correct? And is that because that's the level where the airplanes and jets fly?
Exactly. You got it.
Thank you very much, Tom. Appreciate your time. So again, there you go. That's your 5 o'clock update, what we've been waiting for the past few hours, as the last full update didn't come until last night at 11 p.m.